Today, the future of the world is being decided in two cities. One of them is Washington, D.C. Alan Drury's Advise and Consent. From the time this novel of Washington was first published, it held the number one spot on all of America's bestseller lists for more than 70 weeks during 1959 and 1960, creating unprecedented national interest. From all over the world, correspondents arrived to report on Otto Preminger's filming of the motion picture. Senators, political personalities, international diplomats, newspaper men, and members of the Advise and Consent Company at a party celebrating the start of production. Here, in the heart of Washington, Otto Preminger films the Pulitzer Prize novel, Advise and Consent. It's a story of the men and women who live and work in Washington, their private feuds and public conflicts, which affect the lives of everyone, everywhere. To tell this story, Preminger's cameras move in where no motion picture cameras have ever been permitted. In the very room which saw the Kefauver crime investigation and the McCarthy hearings, Preminger stages another controversial inquiry. A word of warning, these people are all fictional, so don't try to guess who they are.
We want to know what you intend to give away to the communists.
I don't intend to give anything away, Senator Cooley.
What do you know about him?
He's a communist.
Walter Pidgeon stars in the most important role of his career.
You call that a deal? I call it extortion.
Actual members of the White House Correspondents Association become actors to recreate their annual dinner for the President of the United States.
You can tell your readers that the President hasn't changed his mind about his nominee one fraction of an inch. He's going to fight for that confirmation no matter what.
The blonde young man leading the applause is George Grizzard from the Broadway stage, starting a new career in films.
What do you pump water politicians think the world's like? You want to get us bombed out of existence for some lousy two-bit country in Lower Slobovia that can't even feed itself?
Director Preminger's cameras board a warship in Chesapeake Bay to film a scene of political crisis.
I don't know, Mr. President, but the last night I saw Brig Anderson. I saw a man in terrible pain. I wonder if Leffingwell or any one man is worth all of this.
Gene Tierney returns to motion pictures as Washington's most talked about hostess. The setting for her lavish party is the famous estate of a former ambassador to Russia. Among the guests, you may recognize government officials and leaders of Washington society who play themselves. All sides of Washington life pass before the camera lens, from the hubbub of the social world to the suburban homes that appear so quiet from the outside.
Awful creature on the telephone. He knows what he's talking about. He's not making something up. Now, something's going to happen if you don't do what he wants, and you've got to prepare me.
He's dead.
Break.
In his office. Cut his throat.
You want Ray?
Yes, please.
He doesn't live here, you know.
Let me hear a secret voice, a voice that will say, come to me and be what I need you to be.
He will pursue a policy of appeasement. He will weaken the moral fiber of our great nation.
Today, the future of the world is being decided in two cities. One of them is Washington, D.C.